Armies.
And I'm recording.
All right. Okay. Welcome everyone to Eco episode. My mind's a blank. Is it 24 or 23? 24.
24.
Oh, I knew it before I started. I knew what episode it was, and then all of a sudden.
Yeah, we drew a blank.
So. As you can hear, Pam is here. Hello, Pam.
Hello.
And I think that's it for now, unless somebody else
shows up,
drops into the channel, which may or may not happen. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't.
So for once, I'm all caught up on my cooking.
Yes, and we should talk about
our contest.
Yes. Now, Game Edge is not here, as you are probably aware of from some of the previous episodes.
Right, he's on vacation.
Yes, and I think he was in a bit of a panic as he was trying to get ready and
to leave and get everybody packed up and everything else
and all that other stuff.
So he left us in charge of announcing the winner. Of the first game, Eco, copy of the Eco game. There'll be another one, so keep putting your entries in. There'll be another giveaway, but that'll be later on when he's back.
Yes. So there is going to be a bit more of a delay for that one.
Right.
But we have something right now. And would you like to announce the name, Pam?
I would. I'm very happy to announce that the winner of the copy of Eco that is on our giveaway contest was won by Jack Rose.
There you go.
And now, would you like to read Jack's entry?
I'll read it. Now, before I do, I want you guys, you know, there were some really good entries.
Yes, there were some excellent entries.
There was some really, really nice ones, and there were some really good reasons. But I think you'll see, well, you may or may not see, but you'll see. I'm going to read it out. And I think you may understand why we chose this one. So he says, I'm an educator always looking for engaging and educational programs to introduce to kids. A game that encourages community planning and goal setting while simulating consequences for not investing in either has a lot of value. Having a chance to explore this firsthand would help me in crafting a proposal grant for the classroom special. So I think that was all of it.
Yes. And just to explain, the classroom special is Eco sells a package where a teacher can... why don't I read the page about the special?
Yeah. I didn't actually even know about this. Pam had to tell me about this. She knows a lot more about the background and some of the behind-the-scenes stuff with Eco than I do.
Right. The Classroom Special is a digital copy of the game for every student and teacher in a classroom of your choice, up to 100 keys. The students will have the option to alpha and beta test the game as a group and participate in development, listing their names in the credits if desired. Access to source code and art assets of Eco, ability to submit changes for possible integration, direct connection with the team, and the ability to chat with them and share planning tasks. It also includes one membership to the development forums and Slack. So it's a really great opportunity for education. So Jack wants to be able to play the game so that he can... write
as
a
he
proposal.
Puts it, craft a proposal or slash grant.
Right.
Right.
Because the classroom special is expensive. It's $500. He would need a grant for that, and then he could get his whole classroom involved. So, of all the people that wrote, the one thing that we kind of had in the back of our mind was, if Jack wins this Eco Key, it has the potential of turning into a lot of Eco Keys.
Yeah. So it's not just one person winning, it's a whole bunch of people.
Right.
And, you know, it just, that sounded really good. I think that has a lot of merit. Now, should say there were some other really good, compelling entries. But really, you know, this one just had that one extra.
Right, and those entries are still in effect for the next key.
You know, oh.
Yeah, the next week.
I hadn't heard that.
Yeah, this was a two key giveaway. We're gonna give away this week and
that's right.
Next,
I remember.
And then the week after, but so get your keep getting your entries in. You still have a chance to win a key.
Yep.
And Jack, we will hopefully hear from you soon. I'll tell you in the announcement for this. In this video, an announcement. But you can just get a hold of us by probably the best thing to do is go to my About page on my YouTube channel, and there's an email, and you can email me, and we'll get caught up with each other.
Yes. All right. So there we go. I'm glad that we were able to finally get that out. I know that's been in the back of my mind as well. And, you know, we did talk about it quite a bit. And I think actually in the end, Pam and I independently went off and we read the entries and we were, you know, forming our own opinions. And we both came to the same conclusion. So it was pretty unanimous. Jack, there you go.
Congratulations. And
hopefully you and
turn this into a grant.
Exactly. I think that would be great. All right. So plans for today
are I'm all caught up with my store for a change. Everybody's fed, all the food's up for sale, everything's cooked. I'm going to come over and see what Ono's up to.
Yes, so today is roadwork day. big surprise. we're a little behind because of the whole powered cart issue.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to see if I can get down there without ending up in the water again.
I see you walking along in the air with the cart still back at the... That's weird.
Oh.
Cart hasn't caught up with you yet in my video.
Oh, the carts, they're buggy.
Yeah, I'll be glad when they get fixed next patch.
All right, here we go.
Of course I don't.
Where'd my cart go?
I think it's still back at the house, because see, according to me, you walked all the way down here up in the air with no cart.
I am not able to move.
Uh-oh.
Buggy cart is buggy. Oh my god.
See, I still see the cart back up here by your house.
I can't. I'm hopping. I'm trying to move forward and backwards.
I'm stuck.
I'm just stuck here. The cart has... I'm trapped in some sort of...
Try the unstuck command.
Well, no. What I'm going to do, I'm going to log out.
Oh, okay.
I'll be right back.
I'm patiently looking at this card to see what it does.
All right. Let's connect up again. I'm not going to restart the client. I'm just going to restart the connection. That is super weird. Okay, I'm standing in the middle of the road. And the way that when you log into this game,
right,
the way it works is... things will spawn in the order in which they were placed in the world. So, because if the cart did follow me, and I'm trying to keep to the left of the road here so I don't...
See, I still see the cart right up here by your house.
Oh my. Watch, I'm going to try and get on it, and it won't run.
Do you see it down there?
No. I see it up there.
Oh, okay.
Oh, game, please fix the cart. All right.
Now, see, it's still not going with you.
Oh, hang on. I got to start recording again. All right. So I logged back in, ran back up to the house, hopped on the cart, and apparently it's
still
running.
It's still not going with you, though. Oh, no.
According to Pam, it's not. So let's try this again. This is...
Bye, Ono.
This could be interesting.
Yeah, this is interesting. I just see you walking along up in midair, and the cart's still here.
Watch this. Oh!
Maybe we need to restart the server.
And it's disappeared again.
Yeah, it's still here by the house.
According, I think it thinks that I'm still... can you hop on the cart? Just hop on it.
I'm trying. Hold on. It won't let me interact with it.
All right. I'm gonna log off again. I'll be right back.
Okay. Now see, as soon as you left the game, I was able to jump up on it.
Can you do it again?
Hold on. Yeah, I'm on it now.
Okay, can you move it forward just a bit? Just hit the A, W. Okay, stop. Alright, now get off. Alright, now let me try. And of course, now it's not working.
No.
Maybe if I hit it with a pickaxe.
What does hitting it with a pickaxe do?
Make me feel better.
Better.
It's funny, the front wheel looks like it's spinning like crazy. And I could see the back wheel spinning. So it's trying to move. Do you see this wheel spin when I...
No, no. Oops, it just fell over. It just flew all over the place.
Over really?
Your head. Yeah, because you walked into it and it rolled over your head and everything else. I think you and I are seeing totally different things. I think we need to pause the video and do a quick restart. It won't take long to restart the game.
All right. We'll be back.
All right. Quick pause. I'm recording.
Yep, me too. All right, we're back.
We're back and the cart's working?
Well, it was very interesting. You'll notice I'm down by Dredd's house.
Yeah.
That's because that's how far we ended up pushing it, and it would fly through the air.
And bounce around.
And then I'd log in and it wouldn't work, but it would work for Pam, and then it would bounce around, and finally we got it to the point where it would work for both of us. So it's been, what, about 15 or 20 minutes?
Yeah.
So it's... I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, it's frustrating.
It's frustrating. But we got it working, so we're going to continue. At least you guys didn't have to live through all that.
All that, yes. You got the quick version. Snap your fingers and the cart's working version.
Yes, exactly. Ooh, it moves fast downhill.
Oh, it does. I can't keep up with you.
All right, here we go. Dun 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 dun.
Let's hope it stops.
Well, let's hope that it doesn't like despawn out from under me and show up back at the house again.
Yeah.
That's what happened last time. Now I'm a little over to the left in the road, and there's a reason for that. And that's because I want to be able to walk down one side like this and get to the stuff. So All right. And, oh, look, there's dirt. Dirt road. Yay! Have you ever placed dirt road?
No, I haven't.
You want to try? Do you have a shovel?
Yes, I have a shovel.
Okay. Go into the cart. Click storage.
Okay.
And then grab one of the stacks of dirt road and then put it into your carrying slot.
Okay. Done.
Okay. Now you should have a shovel full of dirt. Now come over here. And it should, you should, you know, it'll be obvious where to put it. And you should get a ghost image. You see the ghost image?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then put
you just
it down.
Right click to place. Oh, look at that. Sweet. Oh, and it you make sort of digging motions.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that there was an actual animation associated with it. That's super cool. Sweet.
There we go. Look at that. I built a road.
Oh, and I...
wanted to build an elevated road.
Yeah, well, sometimes it's the little ghost image is in the right place, and then it's...
Right. Sort of just, it jumps.
It just jumps, yeah. I'll grab it. Put it back in the right place. Like that. Womp. Ah, there we go. So there you go. Now you've done road work.
Yeah. Look at that. We're getting close.
I know. You see I put a ramp down already?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's because... Actually, if you want to grab another shovel, go for it.
Well, aren't we done? Aren't you done the bridge now?
I am, but it's going to continue along the sand here. Like
oh, okay.
Because you can't convert sand into road.
Oh, you can't?
No. See, I have a road tool, and if I go over here and I try and convert it into road, it doesn't work. So,
interesting.
Yeah. So either I place dirt road down over the sand, or there's really no or. I mean, I probably could drive on the sand, but I think you're supposed to drive on a road. So how about you do the left hand side? I'll do the right hand side.
Okay.
Yeah.
Need more.
Oh yes. So we're basically taking the road to the dirt over there, the embankment, and then from there we'll have it. It becomes more of an engineering project, where you either tamp down dirt to make dirt road, or oops, I think I almost knocked the cart.
Oh no.
What?
I guess you'll have to pick up that piece that I...
Yeah, yeah, no. I'll do it. That's no problem. It's really easy to do, as you may have noticed. Yeah, just whoop, and then... Whomp. Piece of cake. I think there's a couple more left.
Looking.
So I guess when driving on this road, the general idea when you're going over the water and over the sand and this
right.
is don't accidentally drive off the road. Now, what I could do is this. Because I'm probably going to have to do this anyways in order to tamp the road down.
Right.
And make it level. And then I'll do a controlled thing where I put a ramp somewhere. Are you out?
Yeah, I'm going back to see if there's any. I'm going back to see if there's any more. I think I took the last one.
Yeah, I think you did. That's fine. That's expected. I've got more on the make in the. You make it in the workbench.
Mm, okay.
You just dig up dirt, throw dirt in the workbench, and then convert it. The nice thing about doing it in the workbench is that it does do efficiency.
Ah, so okay.
And you get more. You get more back, right? It multiplies. Whereas if you tamp it down in place, like
right.
this dirt, I'm gonna tamp down this dirt, right? To turn it into road.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's 1-to-1.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I know, this is super exciting. But
I never watched a road being built before. It's kind of interesting.
You're just being nice.
I just kind of watch everything fall into place. It's kind of cool. This is a little different perspective than, you know, probably from your view of putting the things down. I'm seeing your animation, the road change under your feet, and it's pretty cool.
Oh. So now I'm going to do the road tamper. And this is the thing that takes 50 calories per tile, per block.
Oh, wow. You're going to get hungry.
Oh, yeah. That's why you saw the campfire stews.
Mm-hmm.
That's why those campfire stews are in there. That was in anticipation of having to do this. And making road.
Road building is a good workout. Look at the calories it burns.
Oh, it's burning. I'm burning them. Now, technically, what I probably should let's you know what we should do is we should look ahead and try to plan out where the road's going to go. So the road's coming up here, and at a certain point, I'm going to ramp up. I'm not going to, like, carve through all of this grass. I'm going to put in a ramp.
Okay.
So the question, and you saw the turning radius on that thing. It's,
right.
It's not awesome. So right. You need a nice big area to turn. So I'm thinking it's going to go a little bit over this way and then go up this way. And so the question becomes... Oh, you know what I should do is I should have my map open. Come on, map. And there goes my memory. So probably what I'll have to do is I'll come along this way. And then I'll have to go either. Probably it'd be easiest just to ramp down, and then keep going. And then bridge this little section here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you know what? I'm not going in that's not due whatever. Oh, this is a problem.
What's the...
Well, I wasn't going due east and west, right?
Oh.
There's a trick. So let me get a... If I get
okay, this is due east. I'm looking due east.
Yeah. But if here's the dirt, so this is a trick. You can see where the if you put dirt in your shovel, you can't see it, but the viewer can. You if you have dirt in your shovel, it shows you the ghost image, and it'll tell you which is the which is the direction, basically the right direction. So.
Oh, I just use a little compass up in the upper right.
Oh yeah,
corner.
Yeah, that works too. So, most likely this road's going to have to be a bit of a zigzag. Unless I cut over here as much as possible, and then I turn. And go this way.
Yeah, you are going to have to come up off the beach and into this grass and then turn, I think.
Yeah, basically, and then probably turn a bit this way, and then I can go straight this way, essentially. And then bridge this, and then go up here. And then this is where things get interesting. Probably I'll have to start like going up, and then over.
Oops, sorry for the dog barking, guys.
I heard that. Then I think we're practically over here somewhere, but it may be easier to go down on the beach, but then there's water here.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? It'll be easier to go along the beach. Oh, except for right there. Wow.
Why will this be a problem? Because it's too deep?
It's not too deep, actually. So, I think I'm going to come along here. There's just a little deep section right here.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And the nice thing is... this is a change. You can actually dig underwater now. Remember,
yeah,
you couldn't dig underwater
right
before? Yeah, now you can dig underwater. Right now I'm doing scuba work.
Scuba diving.
Yeah.
Scuba work.
Scuba. Now, what would be truly interesting is if you could drive the cart underwater.
No. Oh, you can't get it to drive on the road. Looks like it carried away.
Yeah, I know. So, I think that's the general idea.
Okay.
Is we're going to come along here, but it is basically we're going to go around that foresty section up there with all the trees and everything because
mm-hmm.
it's just it's too much. And then I'm trying to avoid going too much on the sand.
Right.
Oh, you know what? I might end up just having to do that. I mean, I'll just have to pull dirt off of over here and walk it. It's gonna be a lot of work, but I don't think we've got much choice. But at least, by the way, look at this. We're all the way over here now. So, what I should do. Is I'm going to try and wrap this up, but I'm going to wrap it up by putting a ramp down.
Okay.
How much do I need for the ramp? I'll do the dirt ramp. I need one more. I need to remove one more that. Like that. Okay. And we'll just do this and womp.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, woo! And then basically I'll turn this into road and then I think it's this way.
Right.
I have to head like this. And then we'll ramp up and we'll come
right.
Cruise along here. And you know what? I might end up just going down and transporting dirt down onto the beach, because I think that's going to be the easiest way to do that.
Yeah. I mean, it's the straightest shot.
Yeah. All right, what do you think?
Think it looks good.
Okay.
Still a project in work in process, but it's a big project.
It is a big project, so you gotta go big or go home.
Yep.
Yeah, maybe not, but I think I can actually drive on grass, but I don't know if I want to push my luck. What I should be doing is outlining by putting down one block, so the outside block, like this, and then essentially outlining where the road's going to be without putting down four across, right?
Right, and then come back in and fill it in.
And then do the rest, but this way I can figure out where everything's going to be without... Oh, and now I've run out of food. But that way I can figure out where the road's going to go without investing in like a complete... And if I screw it up, I can dig it up. You can basically dig up the converted thing and put it somewhere else. And once you convert it to a dirt road, you
it
can pick
it up. It stays dirt road?
Yeah. If you take a shovel to it and pick it up and then place it somewhere else, it places down as dirt road.
Cool.
So that's kind of nice, actually. And there we go. I am almost fueled up. All right, well, what do you think?
I think it looks good.
Awesome.
I think it's well underway.
All right. I'm going to sneak past you there if you could. Yeah, thank you. We'll go right up one.
The car is cool when it's working.
It is awesome when it's working, which is why it's so disappointing when it isn't. I'm going to go under the grass.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, it should be fine. And then I can turn it around. With its terrible turning circle.
Its turning radius.
Yeah, and then I can... bring it around here and back onto the thingamabobber. There we go. Should we head back to the barn?
Should head back.
So what do you think? Is it doable?
I think it's doable.
Alright.
I think you're doing it, which makes
yes.
it doable.
So right now I'm the idea is that the southern outpost will have, I could do some iron there, a bit of stonework, I could do any number of different things, and then transport back and forth. I could bring
build
in
up till you have a factory.
Yeah, and then I can bring in like food, huckleberries and elk and stuff, and then trade it at the town here. Right.
Right.
And go back. That's the vision. Yeah. I think it's pretty cool.
I think it is.
Yeah, I don't know. I just thought it's like simulating, living out of town and having to
Having to come in and buy your supplies weekly and everything.
Exactly. Da na 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 na. Such a speed demon.
I know. We're gonna have to invent driving laws here.
Alright, it's back. Now what's in the inventory?
In all its glory, it's back. I think it's pretty empty, isn't it?
Well, it's currently got
your food.
It's got a food and a chest. So, what I can do, actually, is put the chest down here. Like that, and then there's nothing in it. Good, and then I can pick it up. It's too heavy. Oh, it's because I have, and food in here. Oops. There we go. Put it away. All right. Woo. So yeah, you'll notice like there's an extra island of dirt over here.
Yeah.
And that dirt used to all be over here.
Here.
Let's just say that there was some...
We had to dig around the cart a little bit in various places.
Yeah, and try different things. And in the end, it was a weird combination of Pam logging out, then me logging out, then Pab logging back in.
We restarted the server.
Restarted the server and all kinds of stuff, so... It's been exciting.
All right. Very exciting.
I think, shall we call that a day?
I think we should call it a day.
All right. And just a reminder that to Mr. Is it Jack
Mr. Rose? Jack Ross, yes.
Is it
Congratulations.
Jack Ross?
It's Rose? Jack Ross. Rose?
Rose, yes. It's Rose. Jack Rose, contact, you heard Pam's instructions. So go through to her YouTube channel, to the About page. There's an email address, and get in touch with her. And the code word is Falcon. So if you use that code, okay.
I'll have 50 emails from people going Falcon, Falcon,
Falcon.
Yeah, we'll verify
who
it is and all of that. That's not a problem. So just use the code word Falcon, you'd be fine. No. So, all right. Okay, I think we're good. I brought us in, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
All right. Well, thank you, Pam.
Thank you, Ono.
You're welcome. And thank you all for watching. It's always good to have you here. And, I hope you enjoy the video. And you all have yourselves a great day.
Good Bye-bye. Night, everybody.